Well, COVID-19 is officially driving the world crazy. At least those in the world who are under lockdown orders. We're just seeing a lot of unrest all around the areas in the countries where there are some pretty stiff lockdown orders. Obviously, here in the United States, we've been seeing unrest for several months. I know that there's a lot of reasons for that. But one big reason is when you take people's jobs away, you give them nothing to do, and you force them to be cooped up inside their homes, they're eventually going to want to come out. And when they come out, they're going to be angry, and they're going to find all of the things they've been angry about are going to swell to the surface, and they're going to come at you with it. And we're seeing that happening here in the United States. Also, it's happening in Germany and in the UK as well. Here's this article. Thousands of COVID deniers protest in Berlin and London. I don't think these people are necessarily COVID deniers. I think that's false reporting. But many of these people are fed up with the lockdown orders. They're saying this is unnecessary. The virus is not nearly as deadly as you guys claimed it would be. Now, you have to remember, here in the United States, they said 2.2 million people would die if we did not shelter in place. And they were saying the same thing in Germany, same thing in UK, different numbers, obviously, with different populations. But nonetheless, they told all of us that if we didn't stay inside of our houses and lose everything we have, our jobs and potentially our homes, that we were going to die. And there have been other countries in this world that did not lock down. You've got Sweden that didn't lock down. You have Belarus. Now, I know Belarus is going through their own issues with their own election, but they also did not lock down. You've got most of Asia did not lock down, except for China and some other parts that did go into lockdowns. But you saw, you know, South Korea did not go into lockdown. Japan did not go into lockdown. But countries where there were lockdowns, we're now starting to see a lot of unrest. People have had it. They will not remain cooped up. Says here, Berlin police ordered a halt to demonstrations Saturday protesting against the German government's COVID-19 regulations, citing the crowd's failure to abide by social distancing guidelines. So in Germany, they arrested at least 300 people for not abiding by masking and social distancing while protesting. They've also been arresting or fining people thousands of euros for not wearing masks. And this has just reached a real boiling point for the Germans, and they have decided that they've absolutely had it. What's interesting, though, is that when you go around the web and you research these protests that have been going on in Berlin, thousands upon thousands of people are out there in the streets. They claim that they are far right. This is how the news paints it. So rather than acknowledging the fact that people have had it, people don't want to be staying, they don't want to be cooped up in their houses anymore for an illness that the average age of death is people 80 years old, mostly in nursing homes. It's not affecting children the way that, you know, it could have potentially if it were a different virus. It's, for the vast majority of us, not a risky virus. And yet we're being told we have to lose everything. And, you know, I mean, it's been, so people have had it. And they're saying, well, then you're far right and you're a COVID denier, because this has really become quite political. How do they go about spreading this fake news that these are far right COVID deniers or far right people, when you've got one of the leaders of this protest was Robert F. Kennedy Jr.? Tell me how Robert F. Kennedy Jr., the son of Robert F. Kennedy, who's also, by the way, a staunch environmentalist, who's an environmental lawyer. He's taken on Monsanto. He's taken on, Roundup. He's very much against fracking. He's for clean water. He's a big time environmentalist. How is that guy somehow now far right? This is how ridiculous this news has become when they paint anybody who says, wait a minute, I kind of have a problem with these lockdowns. I'm not really so sure about this, how far we're going with this COVID stuff. You guys first told us it was 2 weeks. We needed 2 weeks to flatten the curve, stay inside for 2 weeks, and then it became a month. And now it's what, 6 months? So we've got all of these months of being in lockdown. And for what? We're not seeing that this is the doom and gloom that you painted this to be. We didn't see the doom and gloom in Sweden. Now, people want to say, oh, look, it was a disaster there. No, it wasn't. It was not a disaster there. That is a lie. Did they have more deaths than their counterparts in the Nordic nations? Yes, they did. Absolutely, they did. But they did not see the 80,000 to 100,000 deaths that was projected or predicted in the original models. When they said we were going to have 2.2 million deaths, they said Sweden would see roughly, I think it was like 100,000 deaths. They saw 4,000, 5,000 deaths, not the hundreds of thousands of people dead. Not to mention, they didn't have any lockdown orders, and they flattened the curve. They had one death in all of August. That's without wearing a mask. That's without shelter in place orders. They had one death in the entire month of August. They have also reported to have an economy that is that it still took a hit, but not nearly as bad as everybody else in Europe. They came out the strongest out of all of the European nations. Of course, their economy is still tied to the rest of the world. So, of course, they were going to take a hit when the entire world takes a hit. But they came out stronger than everybody else. And more importantly, they came out with mental health that was stronger and better than everybody else. Their children have not suffered. The adults have not suffered. They say that overall, the happiness and the mental health in Sweden is not at the levels it is all around in these lockdown countries. Lockdown countries are seeing skyrocketing suicide rates. We're seeing skyrocketing depression. We're going to see skyrocketing cases of people dying from cancer because they didn't get the early screenings and the early treatments that they needed because everybody was locked down. I know the UK made that announcement. Soon enough, it will come out in the United States. They're not going to make a big deal about it on the news because they don't want you to know that the same number of people are going to die who didn't need to die from cancer because they couldn't get screened early enough because their doctor's offices were closed. They were told, well, take an Advil. That's what they were told during this pandemic. I'm sorry, but this COVID's going to kill you, so you better just take an Advil. For the vast majority of people, COVID was not going to kill them, but cancer will. So people have had it. In the UK, they have had it. In Germany, they've had it. Here throughout the United States, they've had it. We saw the video of Nancy Pelosi going in and getting her hair done. She then claims it was a setup. She says, oh, well, I was set up. The salon owner put in the cameras and they set me up. That's not true. And even if it was true, does it matter if you were set up? I mean, that doesn't work in the court of law. I know that we set people up all the time by having undercover cops doing deals and the person was totally set up. And then they still go to jail. They're still criminals. They still committed a crime. So Nancy Pelosi, even if it was a setup, it doesn't matter. She still went and got her hair done in a salon when we were supposed to be under lockdown orders here in California. That salon owner has every right to be angry, has every right to want to circulate that video around when her business is going under. She was interviewed and she said that her business will not survive. She thought it was going to be 2 weeks of lockdown. 2 weeks turned into a month, then it turned into many months. And now she cannot survive. She's going to have to close her salon down and move out of the state. That is what's going on. And that anger that people are feeling and this, when is this going to end? You guys said we were just flattening the curve so that we didn't overwhelm hospitals. And now it's turned into, no, you have to shelter in place until there's a vaccine. Or it's, well, we're not over this until everybody gets vaccinated and the virus is gone. Nobody talked about the virus being gone. Nobody said that that was the measurement that was going to bring us back to our normal lives and allow us to put food on the table again. Nobody said that that was where we were moving the goalposts. They said, we don't want to overwhelm the hospital system. We don't want you to show up to the hospital and be denied a bed or denied a ventilator or denied care when you need it. So we can't all catch it at once. That was the plan. It wasn't, we're not going to catch it. It was, we're just not going to catch it at once. When they saw that we did have enough ventilators because the federal government went and made sure that we manufactured tons of ventilators. When they saw that we were not overwhelming hospitals, the goalpost moved and it suddenly became, no, you've got to shelter in place and continue losing everything you have until the virus is gone. And you're going to wear a mask until the virus is gone. And now we're going to wait for this miracle vaccine, which of course then creates this panic amongst the scientific community and amongst our government, where they want to release a vaccine on us super early. They want to say, okay, we're going to release a vaccine to you this fall. We're going to have it ready this fall, which is, are you going to take that vaccine this fall? The fastest vaccine ever made for a virus where they've never made a vaccine for any type of virus in this family of viruses ever before, especially if you're not really at risk of dying from this disease. I'm not at risk of dying from COVID. Why would I then take this vaccine that was rushed through so that somebody can politically benefit from this? Obviously, a rushed vaccine at this point would help the Trump administration. Keeping us all sheltered in place and living in fear helps Joe Biden. This has become political. These people are rising up. They know that it's political. People in the UK, people in Germany, they're rising up and they're saying enough is enough. Here in the United States, people are also rising up, but they just don't know where to really direct their anger. So they're putting it in all these other places right now, because we've got a lot of reasons to be mad in this country. A lot of things have gone wrong over the years. There's a lot of desperation and a lot of inequality that these other countries don't face because they have single payer healthcare. They have low cost or free education. In Germany, education is a human right. It's free for everybody, including you, if you were to go to Germany. In the UK, it's free or low cost. They both have low cost to free healthcare. We don't have those things. We have a lot more to be angry about. So people take to the streets, and there's a lot more destruction in the United States. That to me makes sense. I'm not condemning it. I'm not saying it's okay. But obviously, we know that when poverty increases, crime rates go up, violence increases, desperation increases. That is a known fact. And now that we've created this incredible amount of desperation in our society, we're going to see an incredible amount of violence that goes along with it. That is to be expected. Of course, nobody is in these administrations in a Democrat establishment, nor Republicans, are they really truly solving that problem. But I just want to point out that, you know, the news, when they're reporting this, they're again continuing to make this political. They're saying, oh, these far right activists or far right protesters in Germany and the UK, in order to gloss over the fact that all people are fed up from all sides of the political spectrum. That yes, in those protests, are you going to find far right people? I don't know what far right really means in the UK. Probably far right in the UK means a Democrat here in the United States. I don't know what that means over there. I don't know what far right in Germany really means. They're saying that it's anti-Semitism or whatever. Again, I don't think Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is an anti-Semite. I don't think the guy is far right. But this is how they're painting it to keep it political, because they want you to believe that the people that are out there rising up and saying, we call bullshit to all of this, they want you to believe that those people are not politically Democrats. They're insane. They believe in fake news and false narratives, and that they're not on your team, and therefore you should not join them in rising up and saying, wait a minute, this has gone too far. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe. You can also support the channel. The links are down below. And you can also email me if you have thoughts or questions. I would love to receive your emails. I'd love to answer some of your questions here on the show. Email me, Kim@KimIverson.com. Thanks for watching.